This record is a Japanese pressing of the Midnight Express soundtrack by Giorgio Moroder. He won a lot of awards for this soundtrack, but really it's just a Giorgio album. It has all the usual tropes. Judging by the thing on the front, it's a Japanese pressing, so good find.
This is The Monks, and it is a reissue of Black Monk Time. They are a band from the 60s. They cut their teeth in Hamburg, the same place that the Beatles cut their teeth in. I'd never heard of them until Rhys, who's in the band as well, and I went and saw a documentary on them. It would have been like 7 years ago or something like that, at a film festival. And the music just blew my mind.
This record is the Sunshine Band, the Sound of Sunshine. I don't know too much about this one. I know that I have it. It's KC and the Sunshine Band, but before they had the KC and the title. So this record, unlike some of the later albums people have often disassociated with weddings, I have been a long, lifelong defender of KC, but this is just a funk, late funk record, really. It's from Miami, it's 1975. It's quite gritty, actually, given that they went on to be pretty lush. Yes, it's really good. So yeah, anybody that rags on KC and the Sunshine Band, I would say this one's maybe worth a go.
So this album here is We Travel Space Ways by Sun Ra and his orchestra. And this is in the early stage of his career where I think he was still sort of doing a bit of bebop and a bit of kind of like just the regular jazz tropes. But the weirdness is really creeping in here. An amazing starstruck moment for me a few years ago is when we played Mona, the Mona Foma Festival. The same year that the orchestra were playing. I mean, of course, Herman, who was Sun Ra, is dead now, and he wasn't there. But the rest of his orchestra were there in all their kind of various stages of life. To my friend who lent me this record about 10 years ago, I'm going to return it at some point soon.